Jnani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhai Evacha Patitanam Pavhan Ebyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavindra Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing the pastimes of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, how he used his mantra to travel into the spiritual world. And he went into Vaikuntha, and from Vaikuntha he heard about Ayodhya, and then he went on to Dwarka. And in Dwarka he met the Lord Krishna in Dwarka.
他去了百，他去百昆塔，在那里他听说了阿尤迦，从阿尤迦他又继续去了多尔卡，在多尔卡他遇见了主
So when Lord Krishna in Dwarka met Gop Kumar, Lord Krishna was reminded of his pastimes in Vrindavan, and he was reminded of his wonderful relationship with all the people in Vrindavan. The Lord of Dwarka, Lord Krishna, was overwhelmed seeing Gop Kumar in the dress of a cowherd boy. It reminded him so much of his pastimes in Vrindavan. So the Lord Krishna was so overwhelmed with ecstasy, he decided he wanted to get up and leave the assembly. He was sitting in the Sudharma hall, meeting all the leaders of the Yadu dynasty. So, Lord, all the leaders of the Yadu dynasty, when they heard Lord Krishna wanted to go into his own room in private, then all the leaders of the Yadu dynasty, they began to leave. So when the leaders of the Yadus were leaving, Lord Krishna gave them some of his remnants. He gave them pan, or he gave them some sandalwood paste. But he took Gop Kumar, Lord Krishna took Gop Kumar, held him in his right hand, and he took him with him into his inner room, along with Balaram and Uddhava.
然而, 主 Krishna 是亲，就是手拉手牵着 Gopa Kumar， 然后就和 Balaram 以及 Uddhava 就亲自回到了他自己的房间。
Lord Krishna held Gopa Kumar's hand very firmly and brought him with him into his private room.
主 Krishna 是紧紧地拉着 Gopa Kumar 的手，把他带到了自己的私人房间。
And when Lord Krishna went, all of Lord Krishna's queens, they also followed, because Krishna is their husband. And they followed, the queens followed, and the queens came with all their maidservants. So they all came into the Lord's private room.
看见他们的丈夫，起身回到房间的时候，主 Krishna 的众多的皇后们连同他们的女仆们也都跟随着主 Krishna 回到了他的房间。
And in front of all the queens were the mother-in-laws, Devaki and Rohini.
在所有的亚度王朝的这些皇后们当中，有主 Krishna 的母亲 Devaki 和 Rohini。
Devaki is the mother of Krishna, Rohini is the mother of Balaram.
Devaki is Krishna's 生身母亲，而 Rohini is Balaram 的生身母亲。
So among the queens, you know, you have Krishna's eight prominent queens, Rukmini, Satyabhama, Jambavati, and then queens like Kalindi and Mitravinda, and then Satya, Bhadra, and Lakshmana. These are the eight principal queens in Dwarka.
在 Dwarka 的所有的这个王后们当中呢，有八位首要的王后，她们依次是 Rukmini, Satyabhama, Jambavati, Kalindi, Mitravinda, Satya.Bhadra,
Li. Such a Bhadra and Lakshmana.
Lakshmana.
Yeah. Yeah. Just like you've got eight principal gopis, Krishna had eight principal queens.
就像有八位主要的牧牛姑娘，所以也有八位主要的皇后。
So behind them,come all the other queens, 16,100 queens.
在这八位主要皇后后面紧随着16,108位，就是所有的主 Krishna 的皇后也都紧紧地跟随着他们的丈夫。
And they were all very qualified queens. They were all very beautiful, very fit to be the wife of Lord Krishna.And they came along with all their maidservants.
他们这些皇后们，每一位都是美丽绝伦，非常有资格，配得上主 Krishna. 他们也带着他们的女仆们，都跟着一起进了这个房间。
And there's another, there's one of the queens is called Rohini, and she's different from the mother. There's one queen.Called Rohini. Balaram's mother is Rohini, but there's also Krishna got one queen whose name is also Rohini.
主 Balaram 的亲生母亲叫 Rohini, 但是主 Krishna 的王后们当中，其中有一位王后名字也叫 Rohini.
Yes, she was rescued by Krishna. One of the 16,100 queens rescued from the demon Bhomasura.
当巴摩苏拉摩把所有这些国王的女儿们绑架了之后，被主 Krishna 他们都被主 Krishna 解救了。在这个16,100位被救赎的公主当中，有一位叫 Rohini。
So the queens came. The queens are very qualified, and they have very very nice maidservants to assist them.And the maidservants, they carry different things which the queens will use for the service of Krishna. Things like chamara, and boxes containing pan to give Krishna pan.
这些公主的这些皇后的女仆们个个也都是非常的美丽非常的美好，她们手中呢就拿着像 chamar 以及像盛着盼槟榔的盒子来给这些王后们，好让她们服务自己的丈夫夫君。
So Krishna comes into his room with his two mothers and all the queens surrounding him, and behind the queens then they also have all the, many of the young sons, because Krishna had many, he had 10 sons by each queen.
所以主 Krishna 就和他的这两位母亲以及所有的王后们一起 回到了房间，而且在他们身后呢还有所有的儿子们，因为主 Krishna 和每一个公主每一个王后生了十个儿子。
So Krishna was feeling emotion to be with Gop Kumar because it reminded him of Vrindavan, butAt the same time, he didn't want to show that emotion to everyone. He tried to cover it. So, among Krishna's sons, you have people like Pradyumna.Samba, they're the very prominent among Krishna's sons. They were with him.
在 Krishna 的儿子们当中呢 ，Pradyumna 和 Samba 是尤为杰出和突出的两位。他们也在这跟在自己的母亲们后面。
So Krishna seeing Gop Kumar, he remembers about Vrindavan and.He tries, so he sits down on his throne and he's feeling a little, you know, the emotion of remembering his pastimes there in Vrindavan.
看见了 Gopa Kumar, 主 Krishna 就回忆起了 Vrindavan, 所以他非常的感动，他坐在自己的宝座上，心情非常激动不已。
So he feels some pain in the heart because he knows he's thinking about the separation and the pain which the gopis are going through and separation from him. But he wants to make sure that he's happy, that he's in a good mood, because he wants to please Gop Kumar.
主 Krishna 内心非常的痛苦，因为感受到了跟文达文居民的分离之情，他也想着 Gopi 们是如何的因为他自己分离而十分的陷入了痛苦的漩涡，但是他表面上显出了一副轻松快乐的表情，因为他不希望他让他的心情影响到别人，他也希望让 Gopa Kumar 感到愉悦。
Because Gop Kumar's with him, it's almost like he's back in Vrindavan. So Krishna is happy to be back in Vrindavan, and he's happy to be with Gop Kumar.
跟 Gopa Kumar 在一起呢，那种感觉就好像回到了 Vrindavan 一样。所以主 Krishna 就非常的高兴能和 Gopa Kumar 待在一起。
Gop Kumar, however, he doesn't see Krishna in Dwarka. When he sees Krishna, he's thinking that Krishna is with Mother Yashoda. And he's thinking all the people, all the women are gopis. And all the young boys are cowherd boys.
Gopa Kumar 跟主 Krishna 在一起的时候，他不觉得他自己身处在 Dwarka.他感到了主 Krishna 就和他的母亲 Yashoda 和 Gopi 们和所有的牧牛童在 Vrindavan 一样。
So Gop Kumar was meditating on Krishna, and he saw Krishna holding his flute And when he saw, when he was meditating, he fainted. He just fell, collapsed in front of Krishna.
当 Gopa Kumar 他看见了 Krishna 的时候，仿佛他看见，Lord Krishna， 主 Krishna 看见 Gopa Kumar 的时候，他好像感觉到他自己就手拿着笛子，吹着笛子在温达文一样，他是内心如此的激动，他情不自禁，以至于他晕倒在地。
So Gop Kumar, he always worships Madan Gopal. And Madan Gopal is different from Krishna and Dwarka because Madan Gopal always carries a flute.
Gopal Kumar 崇拜的是 Madan Gopal. Madan Gopal 和 Dwarka 的 Krishna 不一样，因为 Madan Gopal 手中恒常地拿着一根笛子。
But when Gop Kumar came there in Dwarka, Krishna in Dwarka took Gop Kumar's flute, and he was holding Gop Kumar's flute in his hand.
但是当 Gop Kumar 来到 Dwarka 的时候， Dwarka 的主 Krishna 就从 Gop Kumar 手中抢过了笛子，拿到了自己的手中。
So when Gop Kumar saw Krishna holding the flute,Then he was thinking about Krishna in Vrindavan, and he saw Devaki. He didn't see Devaki, but he saw Devaki as Mother Yashoda, and he saw Krishna's queens as gopis, and all the sons like cowherd boys.
So, when Gopal Kumar saw Dwarka's Krishna, 手中拿着一根笛子的时候，他看到的就是 Devaki 成为了 Yashoda 妈妈，而那些皇后们就变成了 gopi， 而所有的他们的儿子们就是 Vrindavan 的牧牛童。
Yeah. Krishna in Dwarka is just the same. He's the same person as Krishna in Vrindavan. They're both all attractive, very attractive. And Balaram's mother Rohini, she's also the same because Rohini, she was in Vrindavan. Now she come to Dwarka.
Dwarka 的 Krishna 和 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 都是一样的，最有吸引力的。Balarama 的母亲 Rohini， 她以前在 Vrindavan 居住过。
There was only one difference between Krishna in Dwarka and Krishna in Vrindavan, and that was that when Krishna came to Dwarka, he was wearing the sacred thread, the Brahmana thread.Which had been given to him by Sandipani Muni when he got initiation from Sandipani Muni.
Dwarka 的 Krishna 和 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 只有一个区别，当主 Krishna 到了 Dwarka 之后，他佩戴着他的 Guru Sandipani Muni 授予他的圣线。
So when Gop Kumar fell down.Then Krishna got up and put his lotus hand on Gop Kumar, and it brought Gop Kumar back to consciousness. And Krishna cleaned the body of Gop Kumar and brought him to stand up.
刚才我翻译错了，刚才应该是 Gopal Kumar 他晕倒在地。So just now it's Gopal Kumar who fell down.
Yeah, it was Gopal Kumar fell down. Yeah.
所以这时候呢，主 Krishna 呢，他就把 Gopal Kumar 晕倒在地的 Gopal Kumar 扶了起来，用他的莲花手，然后为他掸去身上的尘土。使他又恢复了知觉，又站了起来。
So although Krishna is the, you know, powerful prince in Dwarka, he's still the son of Nanda Maharaj, and he's very dear to all the cowherd boys of Vrindavan.
即便 Krishna 是一个强有力的王子，但是他依然是南大大军的儿子，依然是那些牧牛童的朋友们。
So he always wants to keep the devotees of Vrindavan happy. So when he saw Gop Kumar faint, he became very anxious about Gop Kumar.
所以他就希望，Vrindavan 的所有的奉献者们都快乐。当他看见 Gop Kumar 昏倒在地的时候，他感到非常的焦虑。
Krishna didn't need to personally get up and do it. He could have helped him just by his own desire. He could just from, because he's in the heart, he could have made Gop Kumar just stand up. But Krishna wanted to take personal care of him. So Krishna personally stood up and he bent down and picked up Gop Kumar and massaged him and cleaned him.
Krishna now.他本来是不需要亲自去做这件事情的，他可以仅仅凭着他的愿力，因为他在每个众生的内心，他凭着他的心愿就可以让高华空儿站起来。但是呢，他却是亲自起来来照顾他，他就弯下腰，然后扶起了高华空儿，还为他按摩，为他掸去身上的土。
So it came time for Krishna's lunch.But Krishna didn't feel like eating, he didn't feel hungry. But his mothers insisted, they said, no, you have to eat something. And so first Krishna did his duties, his noontime duties.
该到了主 Krishna 吃午餐的时间了，但是他没有饥饿感，可是他的母亲就坚持让他一定要吃午餐。所以主 Krishna 呢，首先去完成他的中午的职责。
So, because he'd heard about Vrindavan, so it took away his appetite. But Devaki and Vasudev, they wouldn't. The other ladies, the wives of Vasudev has many wives. They wouldn't let Krishna go without eating. They said, "No, you have to eat."
因为回忆起了文大文，主 Krishna 现在已经胃口没有了胃口，但是 Devaki 和 Vasudeva， 因为 Vasudeva 他有很多的妻子，他们就不让 Krishna 挨饿，他一定坚持他要吃东西。
So he took his midday bath and did his other duties that he would do at noon.
所以主。Krishna 呢，就首先履行了他中午的职责，去沐浴以及其他的职责。
So, Krishna, when he was taking, he didn't eat first. First, he fed Gop Kumar with his own hand. Krishna gave Gop Kumar things to eat.
Krishna 首先呢，就是亲手给 Gopa Kumar 喂食，让 Gopa Kumar 先吃饭。
And then only Krishna took something himself, just to please the people around him.
然后主 Krishna 为了让他周身边的人高兴，所以他也吃了一点。
Right. So Krishna ate because he wants to please his devotees, like Devaki, the mother. She wants Krishna to eat, so he ate. But Krishna also wants his friends to eat.So that's why he gave Gop Kumar.
Chu Krishna, he 可不想让自己的母亲 Devaki 失望，所以他就吃了午餐。但是他也确保他的朋友 Gop Kumar 一定也要吃午餐。
So Krishna sat with Balaram and there was a circle of boys.And they fed them, just as Krishna did in his childhood pastimes. Krishna with the cowherd boys, they would sit in a circle with all the boys. They would sit together and eat. So Krishna sat down in a circle with Balaram and other boys, and they began to eat.
Krishna 儿时的时候呢会跟牧牛童们一起坐下来共进午餐，所以这个时候呢，主 Krishna 就和他的哥哥 Balarama 以及在场的 男孩子们就像儿时那样坐下来，那些他们都围坐在主 Krishna 身边，一起共进午餐。
And so they get the young boys of the Yadu dynasty, they all sit around Krishna and Balaram and they eat together.
Yadu 王朝的那些年轻的男子，那年轻的小孩子们，男孩子们，他和主 Krishna Balarama 都坐下来了，开始吃午餐。
Right, in Srimad Bhagavatam it describes like that, how Krishna is sitting in Vrindavan in the forest with the cowherd boys, and he holds the rice and the yogurt in his hand and eating.
在圣典不加瓦坛当中描述到主 Krishna 在文达文和所有的牧牛头们就一起共进午餐，他手里拿着米饭和酸奶。
And when Krishna's eating like that, all the demigods in heaven, they're all watching, and they're seeing how the Supreme Lord, who is sitting, how he sits with his friends. Usually, the Supreme Lord eats when there's a yajna, but now he's sitting in the forest eating with all the cowherd boys.
人们就从天上观看着至尊主就是吃午餐的情景和他的朋友们吃午餐的情景。通常至尊主会在雅各亚祭祀场上来接受贡品，但是现在他却在森林当中就接受了这些食物。
So Uddhava, who's Krishna's secretary, he knew aboutThe ecstasy which Krishna was feeling because of meeting Gopkumar.
Uddhava is Chu Krishna's 私人秘书，他知道 Chu Krishna 遇见 Gopkumar 的时候，他的狂喜的感受。
So Uddhava took some of Krishna's remnants, took some Mahaprasadam from Krishna, and then he brought Gopkumar. He took Gopkumar by force.He brought him to his own house. Uddhava took Gopkumar to his house.
Uddhava, 他就带拿了一些主 Krishna 的 Mahaprasad, 就强行把 Gopkumar 带到了自己的家中。
Because Krishna was thinking Gopkumar's a cowherd boy from Govardhan, he won't feel very comfortable being in the palace.Where Krishna is living in Dwarka, it's a big palace, it's very opulent. So he thought it would be better if Gopkumar go and stay with Uddhava at Uddhava's house.
Chu Krishna 知道 Gopkumar 呢是一个牧牛童，所以在这个富丽堂皇的宫殿当中呢，可能会有一些不自在的感觉，所以最好呢，他就在 Uddhava 的家中来休息。
Uddhava can understand the Lord's mind without Krishna saying anything to him. Uddhava knows what the Lord is thinking. So Uddhava brought Gopkumar to his house.
Uddhava 呢十分知道了解主 Krishna 的心思，所以不用 Krishna 张口说话，他就把Gopkumar 带到了自己的家中。
And Uddhava also is very familiar with Vrindavan because he'd been there and he knew about the Vrindavan people. He knows how devoted they are.
Because Uddhava 曾经去过 Vrindavan, 所以熟悉 Vrindavan 的居民，知道了解 Vrindavan 的居民的状态。
But you know, because Gopkumar fainted, he was a little dazed, so Uddhava had to drag him practically.
晕倒了，所以有一点眩晕，所以乌德瓦不得不就是带着使点劲儿，把Gopkumar带到自己家中。
So this week Gopkumar came back to consciousness, and then he was remembering what has happened, and he felt great happiness, he felt great pleasure. He would even dance for a long time. So he came to Uddhava's house and he could remember what has happened, and he was so feeling so much happiness that he'd been so fortunate to be with Krishna and to meet Krishna and all his devotees in Dwarka.
在乌德瓦家中呢，嗯，Gopakumar就回忆起发生的事情，他因为遇见主Krishna，感到内心十分的开心，感到非常的万分的幸运，嗯，他能够遇到主Krishna，能遇到Krishna在多尔卡的奉献者们。And
Gopakumar is thinking that, oh, today I fulfilled the goal of my life. With my own eyes, I've personally seen the Lord of Vrindavan. This is the person who I always meditate on in my heart. He is the absolute truth that I want to, that I've always been thinking of him. He's the enjoyer of Vrindavan and he attracts all the devotees. So the next day, Gopakumar goes with Uddhava again to see Krishna. But Gopakumar is so ecstatic, he's so pleased that he's been able to see Krishna, that he wasn't able to do that very much. He couldn't do anything, he didn't know what to do.
He couldn't
think of doing any service. All he could do was just see Lord Krishna. But while he was staying there in Dwarka, he got a lot of mercy from Lord Krishna. It was more than he could explain in words or even think within his mind. Not even a pure devotee within a lifetime could ever think of such pleasure which he was getting there in Dwarka. It's very rare that devotees are able to get into Dwarka and to understand all, to actually directly see the glories of the Lord there with his devotees. People may say happiness, you get happiness and liberation, but that happiness and liberation is nothing compared to the happiness in Vaikuntha.
But
But there's even more happiness. If you go to Ayodhya, the happiness in Ayodhya is even greater than what you get in Vaikuntha.
然而在 Ayodhya 得到的快乐又远远高于在 Vaikuntha 得到的快乐。
But the happiness in Dwarka is even far, far beyond the happiness of Ayodhya.
而在杜瓦卡得到的快乐幸福感又远远超出在阿尤迦得到的快乐和幸福。
The ordinary people, they don't know, they cannot understand the pleasure, the great pleasure which is there in the spiritual world.
普通人是无法理解在灵性世界感受到的、感知到的快乐。
And there's different degrees of pleasure there in the spiritual. It's not all the same.
而且在灵性世界的快乐和幸福还有不同的层级，而且不是一样的。
Okay, so...Only special qualified devotees are able to understand the pleasure which is there in Dwarka.
只有特殊的、有资格的奉献者才能明白在 Dwarka 能够得到怎样的快乐。
People may doubt, how could we get more happiness than what is in Ayodhya?People may think that in Ayodhya there's so much pleasure. How could Dwarka be better than that?
有的人会怀疑，在 Ayodhya 已经能得到如此多的快乐幸福，在 Dwarka 这种快乐幸福又如何能够超越在 Ayodhya 的快乐呢？
They don't understand. They haven't got the intelligence. They haven't got the faith.To be able to understand something higher than what they have experienced.
他们没有这种理解力，因为他们缺乏这种信心和智性，去理解超越了他们的这个智性范围之外的事物。
So, just like devotees in Ayodhya, they get greater happiness.Because they're very intimate in the service to the Lord Ramachandra.
在 Ayodhya 的奉献者们，他们感到十分的快乐幸福，因为他们能够跟主 Ramachandra 有亲密的接触。
The people in Vaikuntha, they don't get the same intimacy as the people in Ayodhya.
在 Vaikuntha 的居民们是，他们和主。的这种联系、联谊的亲密度是赶不上在 Ayodhya 的亲密程度。
But the devotees in Dwarka, their happiness is even more than in Ayodhya because they are all in the mood of friendship with Krishna. They're personally connected to Krishna as friends.
在 Ayodhya, 在 Dwarka 的奉献者们。他们跟主 Krishna 之间是朋友关系，能够跟主 Krishna 有亲身的友谊，所以他们非常快乐。
So we can understand the happiness of Goloka is even greater than that of Dwarka.
以此类推，我们就能明白，在 Goloka 的快乐和幸福又远远超越了 Dwarka 的快乐。
Because in Goloka there's aVery special prema, which is not found anywhere else.
在 Goloka, 拥有在其他地方找不到的特殊的 prema.
So Gopkumar was living there in Dwarka for some time, and then some of the senior members of the Yadu dynasty, they said something to Gopkumar. they were eager to see everyone in the world happy. They wanted everyone to be happy, fully happy. So they said something to Gop Kumar because they were concerned about him.
Gopakumar 在 Dwarka 停留期间呢 ，Dwarka 的长辈们、长者们，因为他们希望看到每一个人内心都全然的快乐，所以这些亚都族的长者们就非常关心他，开始跟他讲话。
Like these men who were like heads, they were like leaders in Dwarka, and they were concerned that everyone should have proper food and clothing and everything they need for their enjoyment, not only externally but also internally. They should be very happy and comfortable. So they came to Gop Kumar to talk to him.
相当于多尔卡的长老长者，他们希望看到每一个人呢都得到充足的食物、衣服，还有一切享受的设施，不仅仅是外在快乐，内心也快乐舒适，所以他们就跟 Gopakumar 讲话。
So they told Gopakumar, they said, you've come here, and you know our place is even more opulent than Vaikuntha. And you are now our companion, you're living here. So we think that it would be better if you could change your dress rather than dress the way you dress, because you dress like this cowherd boy, like, you know, like some person from the forest who lives in the forest. But you're living here in Dwarka,And you know, we people in Dwarka, we don't dress like this, so you should dress like us.
他们就说了，你来到了这里，我们这里的富裕呢，甚至超越了Vaikuntha。你现在既然来到这里了，就是我们的同伴，你居住在这个多尔卡，但是你穿着打扮呢，就像森林里的一个牧牛童。我们这多尔卡的居民们就是不会穿这样的衣服。
They felt they were feeling Gop Kumar's dressed in these miserable clothes, but Gop Kumar was not miserable. Gop Kumar was, you know, he wasn't attached to his dress, so he didn't feel miserable just because of his dress. But they thought Gop Kumar's dress.It's not proper for living here in Dwarka.
他们就觉得 Gopakumar 穿得好可怜，穿得很悲惨。但是 Gopakumar 他根本就不依附自己外在的这个衣服，他也内心没有感到任何一点点，这个悲惨的感觉。
They wanted Gopakumar to enjoy Dwarka as they enjoy it.
他们希望 Gopakumar 就像他们那样子，就在 Dwarka 享受 Dwarka 的富裕。
And they said, Gopakumar, when we see you like this, when we see you dressed in these, you know, miserable clothes of a forest person, we feel pain. We don't like to see you dressed like that. So, you know, we want you to take a dress like us. We have a lot of nice clothes, nice cloth available.We want you to dress also the way we're dressed.
他们看，他们看 Gopakumar， 穿的那么可怜，就是森林里的居民穿的衣服，他们内心就感到很痛苦。他们就是跟他说，我们不希望你穿成这样子。我们这里有很多好的上好的布料，非常精美的华服。我们希望呢，你跟我们穿的都是很华丽，跟我们穿的是一样的。
The nature of the people in Dwarka is they don't like to see any misery or any suffering anywhere. But they thought Gopkumar's suffering. He's in these terrible clothes.
Dwarka 的居民呢，他们天性是看不希望看见任何人痛苦悲伤的，所以他们觉得Gopkumar在受苦，他穿的好可怜。
And we're ready. We can provide everything you need. We can give you nice cloth.Nice dress, you can just be like us.
我们这里应有尽有，我们可以提供你跟我们穿的一样的好衣服。
And they were trying to insist to Gopkumar, but Gopkumar would not agree. And Gopkumar said, no, I'm not going to change. I like my clothes. I just stay here. I just want to be like I am. So Gopkumar stayed like a poor devotee dressed in...His dress.
但是 Gopkumar 他说，我觉得我不感觉我自己穿的有什么不好的，我喜欢这样子，我就想穿的像这样的衣服。然后但是Dwarka 的居民就觉得他们很可怜。
Gopkumar knows.That his dress, which he's wearing, it helps him to keep the mood of Vrindavan and to taste that special pleasure of Vrindavan and to remember the pastimes of the Lord there in Vrindavan.
Gopkumar, he 希望保持自己的穿着，这能帮助他保持在 Vrindavan 的心态，品味。Vrindavan 的快乐，想着主 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的逍遥。
Gopkumar knew he wasn't worried about his appearance, but he wanted to keep his personal relationship with Krishna. And that dress was important for him to keep that personal rasa with Krishna.
Gopkumar 不担心，不在意自己的外在的衣着。他希望保持跟主 Krishna 之间的亲密的关系，而这样的衣着能够让他始终处在跟 Krishna 的特殊的 rasa。
So after that happened, then Gopkumar was a bit shy, and he didn't like to go near Krishna. He didn't like to come close to Krishna because he thought, I'm dressed in these old clothes, they don't really like me coming in this cloth. So he felt uncomfortable.
在这个事件发生之后， Gopkumar 就有点害羞了。他就不再像以前那样跟 Krishna 非常的亲近。他就心里想，我穿的这些衣服那么破那么旧，他们可能不喜欢我穿这样的衣服，所以这件事发生之后，他内心就有点不自在。
So he didn't want to create any problem there in the assembly when Lord Krishna would come and sit in the assembly. So Gopkumar would keep far away, keep in the back of the behind the crowd.Because he thought if Krishna sees, if they see me, they'll feel uncomfortable.
所以 Gopkumar 他不希望就自己的这个穿着能够就给别人制造麻烦，所以每当这个聚会的时候呢，他远远的就站在众人的身后，他不希望别人看见他这个样子呢，感到内心不舒服。
And so Gopkumar, he thinks that, maybe I shouldn't stay here any longer. Maybe I need to go somewhere else.
Gopkumar, 这时候就想，也许我不应该留在这里，也许我应该去别的地方了。
And sometimes when he would go to see Krishna, he would see Krishna with four hands.He would see him in Krishna in his four-arm form. He couldn't always see the Krishna which he knew in Vrindavan.
有的时候 Gopkumar 看见主 Krishna 是四臂的形象，他不 不能总是看见主 Krishna 像 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 那样子。
Especially when Krishna would be with, when Krishna would be with Rukmini, then it would be difficult for Krishna to think about. It would be difficult for Gop Kumar to think about Krishna in Vrindavan, because you know Rukmini, she's not there in Vrindavan.
尤其是当主 Krishna 跟 Rukmini 在一起的时候。Gopa Kumar 就不会联想起 Vrindavan 的 Krishna， 因为 Rukmini 没有去过 Vrindavan。
And sometimes Krishna would be talking with Narada Muni or Arjuna, then Gop Kumar, he couldn't think about Krishna being a cowherd boy, because Narada Muni and Arjuna, they're never taking care, they're never there in Vrindavan pastimes.
有的时候，主 Krishna 也和 Narada Muni 和 Arjuna 在一起，所以这个每当这时候呢 ，Gopa Kumar 就不会把主 Krishna 跟牧牛童联系在一起，因为 Narada Muni 和 Arjuna 呢也不在 Vrindavan 的消失光当中。
So sometimes Krishna would go with his friends the Pandavas, and they would go alone. Krishna would go alone.To be with his, the friends of Pandavas. The Pandavas were also living there in Dwarka nearby.
有的时候，主 Krishna 他是独自一人和 Pandava 五兄弟在一起，他那五兄弟就居住在附近。
Yeah, on this planet Earth, the Pandavas would live far away from Dwarka. They would live in Hastinapur, which is a long way from Dwarka. But in Vaikuntha.It's different. In Vaikuntha, they live near to Krishna.
在地球上，Dwarka 和 Hastinapur 是有一段很远的距离，但是在 Vaikuntha, Dwarka 和 Hastinapur 是很近。
Because it's a spiritual world, so any place Krishna wants to go, it can be very near. He can go there immediately.
因为那是灵性的世界，所以任何两个地方距离都不远，只要主 Krishna 想去，立刻就能到达那里。
So Gop Kumar's got these desires in his heart, so he's not so peaceful.
一旦 Gopa Kumar 内心了有了这个心愿之后，他就失去了往日的平和。
But when he would see Krishna, when he would see Krishna's beauty and his wonderful qualities, then he would become peaceful.
但是他每当见到主 Krishna 的英俊美丽，他的品格的时候，他又再次感到内心平静下来。
And he would hear Krishna speak. His words would show the wonderful mercy of Krishna.
当他听 Krishna 讲话的时候， Krishna 的话语就展示了他美妙的仁慈。
And Gop Kumar would feel so much happiness just hearing Krishna speak, hearing Krishna's words.
Gopa Kumar 因为听到 Krishna 讲话，听到 Krishna 的话语，感到非常的开心。
So while he's living in the house of Uddhava,If there was any unhappiness, if he had any unhappiness, he would try to, Gop Kumar would try to cover it up, and he would pretend that he was happy.
So when he lived in Uddhava's house, when he had a little bit of unhappiness, he would pretend that he was happy.
Yeah, sometimes Krishna would feel he would be absent from Dwarka. That would make Gop Kumar unhappy.
有的时候主 Krishna 离开多尔卡，每当这个期间 Gopa Kumar 就会感到闷闷不乐。
And sometimes Gop Kumar would remember Vrindavan, his home, the place of his birth, and that time then he'd also feel unhappy.
而且有的时候 Gopa Kumar 想起他的诞生地，想起 Vrindavan, 每当这个时候他内心也有一些不快乐，闷闷不乐。
So when he couldn't see Krishna, when he couldn't see Krishna as a cowherd boy playing the part of the pastimes in Vrindavan, he would feel unhappy. But he would try to hide it, because he knew the people in Dwarka, they don't like to see anybody suffer.
每当他看不见主 Krishna 就像牧牛 Vrindavan 的牧牛童的样子的时候，他就那感到不太开心，但是他会竭力掩饰他的不快乐，因为多尔卡的居民不希望看到任何人痛苦。
So one day, while Gopkumar's in Dwarka, Narada Muni came. So when Narada Muni came there, Gopkumar bowed down to him and he began to speak with Narada Muni.
有一天 Narada Muni 来到了 Dwarka. Gopkumar 见到 Narada Muni 就开始顶拜他跟他讲话。
And Narada Muni's come just at the right time. He's going to tell Gopkumar about Goloka and about how Gopkumar can go to Goloka and see Krishna in Goloka.
Narada Muni 来的正是恰逢其时，因为他要告诉 Gopkumar 有关 Goloka 的事情，他可以去看见 Goloka 了。
So we'll hear about Gopkumar when he goes to Goloka. We'll continue next week.
We'll 我们下一周讲 Gopkumar 去 Goloka.
Okay, we'll stop here today. Are there any questions? Is there any question?
Yes, yes. In Maharaj, there are Christians from today, okay. 淡然一笑。Krishna 是拥有最高完美品位的那一个人。其品位具体是指什么？ Krishna have the highest perfect taste. So she wants to know what that taste refers to.Krishna, because Krishna is the one who have the highest, perfect, in Chinese it's said taste. I guess it's a rasa that. So she wants to know what that specific taste or rasa refers to.
Well, it talks about, rasa refers to loving relationships between the Krishna and his devotees.
它是指的 Krishna 和他的奉献者之间的关系，爱的关系。
The love, the devotees of Krishna, they have special exchanges with Krishna, which give him great pleasure.
Krishna 和奉献者之间的这种交流，爱心交流，就给他带来巨大的快乐。
We all, in the material world, we all enjoy these different relationships with each other, with our friends, we have our lover, we have our intimate friends, we have parents, we have lovers like that. This is how we get pleasure in the material world.
在物质世界呢，人和人彼此之间就形成了各种关系。我们有亲密的好朋友，
you don't,
父母亲，还有伴侣，这些关系都能给我们在物质世界呢，人们是通过这样的关系获得快乐的。
So the same way, Krishna also He has his taste for enjoying, and he gets his enjoyment from the company, from the friends he keeps, from the devotees who are around him, from the cowherd boys, and from the gopis, and from his parents.
同样的，主 Krishna 也是从这各种各样的享受当中得到特殊的品味，他从他的同伴、他的朋友、他的奉献者、勾品、牧牛童，从这些他的父母亲、他的关与他们之间的关系得到这种品味。
Okay, yeah.
Then next one is also fun. 淡然一笑，如何将奉献服务的对象由幻觉转向真实？ How can we change the object of our devotional service from illusion to reality?
So the reality is found in the spiritual world, in relationships with Krishna. And the illusion is in the body.
真实是在主灵性世界，在主 Krishna 身上可以找到这种真实，幻象是在这个局限于我们的躯体上面。
We are living in the illusion of the material world.
我们居住在，我们正是居住在物质世界的幻象当中。
And this world is just like a dream, just like you have we have dreams at night. So this is our daydream, but it's all illusion. It's not eternal.
正像我们晚上黑夜睡觉的时候晚上会做梦，现在呢我们是在做着白日梦，这些都是幻想。
The reality is in the spiritual world. We have a spiritual body and we have spiritual connections in the spiritual world. We have friends and family, everything is there in the spiritual world, in spiritual bodies.
我们有灵性的，我们有我们自己的灵性的躯体，我们也有这些灵性的关系，有灵性的朋友和灵性的家人，在灵性世界我们有这些关系。
So you come out of the illusion by developing your Krishna consciousness.
您是通过发展 Krishna 知觉来摆脱幻象。
Just like at night you dream, you have to wake up. Somebody, you wake up from your sleep and you come to see your existence. So we're in this dream of material world. And we have to wake up, come out of the dream.
就像在夜里如果你做梦你醒来之后呢就回到现实生活当中，同样呢，我们在物质世界，我们在做着物质的梦，我们应该从物质的梦境当中醒过来。
OK。
下一个来自喜宝。
Yeah, 喜宝。
这个 long question。
喜宝。
Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和老师们，我今天想请教 Guru 关于念诵圣名的问题。 Guru 在爱的觉醒的讲课中对念诵圣名举了一个他自己在印度患黄疸病的例子。我自己也常常出现念诵时候不专注，特别容易分心，甚至早上四五点钟拿起念珠就想打瞌睡，但是我在这个时候一边念诵一边翻手机看 Krishna 的照片，或者看自己在印度朝圣的图片，注意力很快就会专注起来。请问 Guru， 这是冒犯吗？还是可以被允许的一种快速调整的方式呢？感恩你。
Yes, You can think like that, no harm. You think of yourself in the holy land with Krishna. You think of yourself with the devotees engaging in devotional service. I think that's all right. If it's helping you to chant. The idea is, however, to hear the mantra.
是的，你可以想象自己就在正想着自己就跟主昆士呢和奉献者们在一起，在那里在从事着服务，可以怎么去做？如果这样能帮助你的念诵，但是呢，要点就是。
And so we keep, we prefer when you keep pictures, better not to keep pictures of yourself because you get attached to, you know, you're thinking you're the body. You want to get attached to the holy place. It's better you have pictures where you're not in the picture. Like you have a picture of Vrindavan, but not you. I remember there was one devotee. This was in the Philippines. The one devotee, he went to India and he took his picture everywhere. He took pictures of all the deities, and in every picture of the deities, he's sitting in front of the deities. So you look at the deity's picture, but he's sitting there in front of the deity, so he's really looking at himself. So that's not really good.
我记得有一位菲律宾的奉献者呢，他就去印度朝圣的时候呢，他每次照相的时候呢，就是这个相片当中的图像呢，就是他坐在神像面前，这样呢，每次其实他看这个相片的时候，他看的其实是他自己，那么这样呢，不是特别好。
Right, we don't want to think about ourselves so much. We want to think of ourselves as a servant of Krishna. We want to think of Krishna. But if you look at the picture of yourself, you become attached to your own self. You're thinking, yeah, well, I'm very nice. I'm, you know, we're thinking I'm the body.
我们呢，就是不应该过多的把注意力关注在我们自己身上，想着我们自己。我们应该是把注意力放在 Krishna 身上。我们不应该是依附我们自己，因为当我们看到这些自己的图片的时候呢，就容易呢把自己还是认同于自己的躯体。
So we know we're attached to our body. We want to change that attachment. We want to get attached to Krishna, right? We want to see ourselves in relation to Krishna.
我们不希望自己能还是依附这个躯体，我们应该转而依附 Krishna。我们应该是想着我们自我和 Krishna 之间的关系是什么。
So remember, we're not the body, and if we keep pictures of our body, then we just simply think, that's me, I'm the body. We have to think of ourselves as a soul, part of Krishna. So we seek pictures of Krishna, we don't look at pictures of ourselves.
So, 我们每当看见这个我们自己的在图片照片上图片呢，就会想这个躯体就是我。那实际上呢，我们是灵魂，我们都是 Krishna 的所有部分。我们应该是看 Krishna。
It's a subtle point. It's good you brought this up because many people, many devotees, they're not aware of this, and we do this. We're more attached to ourselves than we are to Krishna.
你能就是提出 你这个问题非常好，因为呢，它涉及到了非常精微的一个问题。因为这个我们就会把注意力呢，就是关注在照片上的自己的身体上。我们应该是依附的是 Krishna， 而不是照片上那个躯体。
So it's better you just look at pictures of Krishna and chant.
所以，更好的方法就是看 Krishna 的照片，然后念诵。
We keep pictures of the holy places, pictures of the deities, pictures of Krishna's different incarnations.
我们就是保存的是圣地的照片、相片，保存着神像的相片，保存着 Krishna 各个化身的相片。
Because we want to think of Krishna, we don't want to think so much about ourselves.
因为我们希望的是我们是意念 Krishna, 而不是意念我们自己。
Because we don't know.We forget, we are thinking, this is me, I'm the body. But we're not the body, we're parts of Krishna.
We don't know, because we've already forgotten. We'll think, this is me, but this is not me. We're the body, we're Krishna's
part. And we all have spiritual bodies. When we go back to Godhead, we'll go back to our...We'll develop our spiritual body. You don't know who you are in the spiritual world.
We all have our spiritual bodies. We will develop our spiritual body. We don't know who you are in the spiritual world.
Okay, any other question?
Yes, the next one from Chandra Velasini.Dadasi, 虔诚的顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜奉献者，请教 Gurudev, 我们做服务是要学 Guru, 学 Krishna, 那么在灵性世界得到快乐多少的状态，得到的快乐多少的状态也是努力做服务，只想取悦 Krishna, 心态的不同程度自动获得不同的快乐吗？感恩孤儿的仁慈还是 Krishna？
The last part I didn't understand. 自动是什么？
How much we get the happiness is depend on.On the degree we want to please Lord Krishna,、and according to that degree, we get how much happiness. On the degree we want to, the mood we want to please Krishna, and accordingly we get the happiness. Is that?Is that right?
Yes, you could say that's correct. That to the degree that we want to get, to the degree that we want to please Krishna, we will get that much happiness. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, as you surrender unto me, I reward you accordingly. So when we surrender fully to Krishna, then Krishna will certainly reward us fully.
就是根据我们在多大程度上想取悦 Krishna， 我们就会得到多大程度的快乐。就 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》当中就说了，我依照一个人对我的皈依程度，我给予相应的回报。如果一个人他要是全然的臣服 ，Krishna 就会给他全然的回报。
We get the ultimate happiness from Krishna, from pleasing Krishna.If we can please Krishna, then certainly everyone will become pleased. The whole planet, all living entities will become pleased.
我们就会相应的得到最终极的快乐。倘若我们希望是学主 Krishna， 那么人人都会感到快乐，所有的众生都会感到快乐的。
And Krishna is pleased where there is real devotion, genuine devotion. Nothing else pleases Krishna other than pure devotion.
除了真正的奉爱，除了纯粹的奉爱之外，没有什么能够让 Krishna 开心。
And the ultimate devotion is there in prema bhakti. When you come, not just simply sadhana bhakti or bhava bhakti, but prema bhakti, the highest, the goal of all devotional service, to develop love for God, pure love.
终极的奉爱 prema bhakti 能够取悦 Krishna， 而不是 sadhana bhakti 或者是 bhava bhakti， 就是最高程度的纯爱 prema bhakti。
So it's a very rare thing that one can develop that kind of love. It's not ordinary. It's a very, very, very rare.
一个人能够发展到这种程度的爱是十分十分罕见的，不是很普稀松平常的事情。
So to please Krishna,it's an ongoing thing. We are trying to please Krishna more and more, and you know, we have to purify ourselves more and more. We have a long way to go.
So this is a continuous process. We have a lot of pollution to be purified.我们还要需要做的事情还有很多，这个是一个很遥远的路程。
Okay, anything else?
Yes, 下一个是 Radna Mala Devadasi， 顶拜 Guru， 顶拜所有的奉献者。请问，杜瓦尔卡的 Krishna 和 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 为什么不一样？有什么区别？优点是哪里？还是可是呢？不如的简单。
Okay. Well, Ayodhya is the place of the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra. Lord Ramachandra, his palace and his residence is there in Ayodhya.
Ayodhya 是主 Ramachandra 上演逍遥时光的地方，主 Ramachandra 的宫殿。
And Krishna in Dwarka and Krishna in Vrindavan, it's the same Krishna, but he's in a different mood and he's performing different activities. Because Krishna in Vrindavan is a cowherd boy, but Krishna in Dwarka, he's a prince.
Dwarka 的 Krishna 和 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 是同一位 Krishna。只是心态不同，有不同的活动。在 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 是一位牧牛童，但是在 Dwarka 的 Krishna 是一位王子的身份。
Just like somebody may go to they may have the job in Beijing and they go to Beijing and they do their job and they're, you know, maybe they're a, you know, maybe they've got a job in the office or something, but when they go home, they go back to their village.And they're just in the village with their family, mother and father. They're different, you know, different rasas, different conditions.
比如说一个人呢，他在北京找了份工作，他就会去北京的办公室上班。然后呢，他的家是在乡下，在村里，他有自己的父母亲。所以呢，这是不同的 rasa， 不同的环境。
And we said today, Krishna in Vrindavan is different from Krishna in Dwarka, because Krishna in Dwarka he's wearing the Brahman thread, because after Krishna was in Vrindavan, he went to Mathura and killed Kamsa.And then Vasudeva and Devaki had been in prison, they brought them out of prison, so they wanted Krishna to go to Sandipani Muni's ashram and get education, And when he was there, he got initiation and he got the Brahmin thread. So Krishna in Dwarka wears the Brahmin thread.
Krishna呢，他是佩戴圣线的。OK，
还有问题吗？
最后一个问题是淡然一笑，薄伽梵歌的核心有哪些？薄伽梵歌的核心
essence 怎么说？核心的
essential point。
Bhagavad Gita, what's the essential point of Bhagavad Gita?
Yes.
Well,
key point.
The key point. There are different key points in the Bhagavad Gita. You could say one key point is, at one point Prabhupada said, the most important verse in the Bhagavad Gita comes in the fourth chapter. I think it's the ninth verse. Janma karma cha me divyam evam yo vedi takvataha takvadeham punarjanma naiti mamiti sorjuna. That one who can understand the birth and activities of Lord Krishna, then upon giving up this body, they don't come back to this world again. They will go back to Godhead.
圣帕帕德曾说过，薄伽梵歌的最重要的一个诗节是第四章诗节九，Janma Karma Cha Me Divyam，就是谁若了解我出生和显现的活动，在放弃这个物质躯体之后，他将不再投生在这个物质世界，而是回到我永恒的居所。
So Prabhupada said that's a very important verse because Krishna is saying you don't have to come back again in the material world. However, you got another verse which comes at in the ninth chapter of Bhagavad Gita is called the most confidential knowledge. And you get the most confidential knowledge, it comes at the end of the ninth chapter.
还有一个重要的篇章是薄伽梵歌的第九章，第九章的标题是机密的知识。
Krishna says, engage your mind in thinking of me, become my devotee, worship me and offer obeisances to me. In this way you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you're my devotee.
就是你心里恒常想着我，成为我的奉献者，崇拜我，顶拜我，这样你毫无疑问一定会来到我这里。So
that's the most confidential knowledge. And then you've got another key verse which comes in the 18th chapter. Where Krishna says, Sarva Dharmam Parikrishna Mamikam Sharanam Braja. Krishna is telling Arjuna to surrender everything. And just to hear, Krishna says, give up all forms of religion and simply surrender unto me. I will free you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear.
关键的世界是第十八章，在第十八章当中，主 Krishna 就讲了 Sarvadharma Pratyajan， 你放弃一切宗教，臣服我，我将把你从一切恶报当中拯救出来，不要害怕。
So these are some key verses. There are many other key verses. It depends which particular facts you're looking. What are you looking for from the Bhagavad Gita? It will be different for different people. What level are you at in your bhakti?
These are all the
key
verses of the Bhagavad Gita. This also depends on what you're looking for.目标不同的人他有不同的目标，也取决于每个人所处的层面，也取决于他自己所修行的他的 bhakti 的不同层面。
At the end of the sixth chapter, Lord Krishna has been describing the yoga ladder through chapter 3, 4, 5, and 6. He's describing the progression in yoga, and at the end of the sixth chapter, he describes that the topmost rug on the yoga ladder is to be his devotee. Yogi namapi sarvisham madgatenantaratmanam shradavam bhajatem yumam same yuktatamo mata. Of all yogis, the highest yogi is the one who is always thinking of me and engaged in my transcendental loving service.
In Bhojavanga's第六章中就描述了这个瑜伽的各个阶梯，在头第三四五章当中描述了瑜伽的进程，而到了第六章就描述瑜伽的最高阶梯，就是the last verse of sixth chapter, right?
Yeah.
就是我读一下这个第六章的诗节47。在所有的瑜伽师中，谁对我信仰坚定，常处我中，内心时刻想着我，以超然的爱心服务于我，谁就通过瑜伽和我最亲密的连在一起，谁就是最高级的瑜伽师。这就是我的意见。
So these are some different verses, which are nice, important verses.
以上就是国家梵歌当中的非常美好的一些关键诗节。
Is there any other question?
The next one is from PPLU. 顶拜敬爱的 Gurudev， 请问为什么 Gopal Kumar 心中有时候看到是四臂形象的 Krishna， 有时候是两臂的呢？我听说奉献者心中的超灵形象是不一样的，有四臂的。纯粹奉献者的心中是两臂的吗？这与奉献者的知觉有关系吗？
Yes, well, it depends. You see, Gop Kumar, sometimes he would see Krishna in the mood of Vrindavan, and sometimes he wouldn't see him in the mood of Vrindavan, sometimes he would see him in the mood of Dwarka.
就是 Gopal Kumar, 他有的时候看到的主 Krishna 是处在 Vrindavan 的心绪当中，有时候他看到的主 Krishna 是处在 Dwarka 的心绪当中。
So sometimes he would see Krishna in forearms, he would see him as the Lord of Vaikuntha, as the King of Dwarka, the Prince of Dwarka, and he would see him with four arms. But other times he would see him more in the mood, just like we said, sometimes he would see Krishna, and Krishna would be with his mother Devaki, but Gop Kumar would think that this Devaki was Yashoda. And the gopis, the queens who are there with Krishna, Gop Kumar would think they're gopis. And the children of Krishna who were there, Gop Kumar would think they're cowherd boys. And so he would see Krishna in different moods. Sometimes he would see Krishna in Vrindavan, where he's got two arms, and sometimes he would see him in Dwarka, and sometimes he would see Krishna with four arms.
有的时候呢，Gopal Kumar 看到 Krishna 是四臂Vaikuntha之主，有时候看到他又是多尔卡的一位王子。有时候呢，格巴库玛看到德瓦基，就看到德瓦基的时候呢，他就看好像看到的是亚修的 那些勾嫔们、牧牛姑娘呢，那王后们呢，她看到的好像就是牧牛姑娘，而那些就是多尔卡的那些孩子们、男孩子们，她看他们就好像是他们的牧牛童们。就这样呢，有的时候她看到的 Krishna 呢是在文达文的心绪当中，有的时候她看到 Krishna 是在多尔卡的心绪当中。
Did I answer all of his question?
The next part is about the super soul in the heart.
Right. What he wants to know, is it two arm or four arm?
I heard the super soul in the heart of devotee are different. Some are four armed, but the pure devotee is two armed. So she asked, is this relevant to the consciousness of devotee?
Yes, it is. Depends on the consciousness of the devotee.
是的，这取决于奉献者的知觉。
Somebody is conscious, somebody is meditating on the super soul, like the yogi, he's meditating on the super soul. So he sees Vishnu in the heart with four arms.
是的，是跟知觉有关系。有的奉献者他冥想的超灵，比如说像瑜伽师，他冥想的是内心的Vishnu，他就是四臂的。
But a devotee of Krishna is worshipping, thinking of Krishna in Vrindavan, they're not going to see, they'll see in the heart, they will see Krishna, they will see Krishna with two arms.
然而如果是主 Krishna 的奉献者呢，就是 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 奉献者，他看到的内心的超灵就是两臂的 Krishna 形象。
So it's a question of how we're devoted, which form of the Lord you're devoted to, which form of the Lord you're meditating on. Somebody's simply meditating on the Lord as the super soul, and somebody's meditating on the Lord as Sri Krishna, the Lord of Vrindavan.
这就取决于你是主的哪个形象的奉献者。你崇拜的是主的是哪个形象？如果是崇拜的是超主在众生当中的，就是超灵的话，是冥想的是就是超灵形象的，还是冥想的是本达本的圣主 Krishna Sri Krishna？
Is there any other question? Yes.
Yes. Is that the answer to her question? 下一个是，下一位是奉献者淡然一笑。Bhishma 是主的奉献者，却不追随主，是不是寓意着人的第一责任是履行当下责任，其次才是为主做奉献服务？但我个人觉得说不过去，请老师讲讲我这个疑虑。Bhishma is the devotee of the Lord, but Bhishma didn't follow the Lord. So does that mean that one has to carry out his duty, then to do devotional service for the Lord?
She's saying one should first carry out one's duty, and then do devotional service for the Lord.
Because she thinks that although Bhishma is a devotee, but Bhishma didn't follow the Lord.
Yeah, Bhishma didn't, he fought on the opposite side from the Lord. But although he was fighting on the opposite side of the Lord, still, he was devoted to the Lord.
是的 ，Bhishma 是站在主的对立方，在跟主作战。但是，即便如此，他仍然是主的奉献者。
So Bhishma, he had some obligations because he'd been living in the palace, he'd been staying with the Kauravas, And he'd been eating their food. So when they came to the battle, he was obliged to fight for the Kauravas. And as it meant, he had, Lord Krishna, he was fighting, he was chariot driver of Arjuna. And so Bhishma and Krishna were on opposite sides, but still Bhishma is devoted to Krishna, and he thinks of Krishna as the Lord.
Bhishma, he is located in Kaurava's temple, and he is holding their feathers, and he is eating their food, so he has an obligation. 所以而主 Krishna 是 Arjuna 的战车御者，因此呢，他们两个呢是交战的对立方。但是即便如此，嗯，在 Bhishma 他仍然是主 Krishna 的奉献者。Before
the battle of Kurukshetra, both sides wanted to get Krishna on their side. So Duryodhana and Maharaj Yudhisthira, they both come there to see Krishna, to get him to join their side. And so Krishna said, well, he said, I'm not going to fight, I'll just be the driver, I can be a chariot driver. So one side can get me to be chariot driver, and other side can get my army. So when Duryodhana heard that, he said, well, I would prefer to have your army. And so Krishna became the driver for Arjuna, and Krishna's army went and fought for Duryodhana. And so you could see, you know, although they were on different sides, they were all, you know, there was some friendship there. It wasn't like a usual war.
Krishna 能站在自己的这一方，因此呢，他们都来找主 Krishna。但是主 Krishna 说：“我不参战，但我不参战。但是一方呢，可以，我就是得到我的军队；另一方呢，我可以为他驾驶战车。”所以杜尔丹呢，他就希望有得到主 Krishna 的这个军队，所以他就得到了主 Krishna 的军队，而。 Yudhisthira大君呢，他就希望Krishna能够就是当他们战车御者。所以，但是不管怎么说，这不是一个普通意义上的一个战争。So
Bhishma, although he's not following Krishna, he's not fighting with him, he's fighting against him, but still in his heart, he surrendered to Krishna, and he accepts Krishna as the Supreme Lord.
虽然老祖父Bhishma是站在主 Krishna对立方在跟他作战，但他的内心却是主 Krishna的奉献者，是全然臣服的。And
when Bhishma was on the bed of arrows at the his passing away, when he departed from the world, Krishna came there to see him.
在他临终之前躺在箭床上的时候，主 Krishna 就亲自来见他。And
Bhishma gave up his body, looking at Krishna.
Bhishma 就凝视着 Krishna 莲花脸，放弃了自己的物质躯体。So
he could go back to Godhead.
他就这样回到了神手。All
right. 还有问题吗？
还有一个 Janaka Das Prabhu， 请问 Gurudev， 有位奉献者前天隐寂了，今天要火化，奉献者都需要去那里送行吗？ 没有去送行的奉献者，在家唱诵意念可以吗？ 那些去了的返回是否需要沐浴后才能来联谊呢？ 奉献者们还需要做什么呢？ So, Janaka Prabhu is asking that there is a devotee who passed away the day before yesterday, and today there will be
cremation.
Will be burned. Yeah, cremation. And he asked, Dana Prabhu asked, is it that all devotees need to go there to say farewell to the devotee? And those who are not going there, can they stay at home and chanting and remembering? And the next question is that about those devotees who went to the cremation, and do they need to take a bath and then come back for association? And he further asked does he need to do?
Well, yes, it's up to the individual if they want to go to the crematorium. It's a personal decision. If somebody has some intimate relationship with the person, they may like to go there for the cremation just out of respect. They go there and attend the cremation.
这是个人的事情，看他们自己是不是去火葬场，看他们跟这个奉献者之间是不是有亲密的关系，他们是不是喜欢去那里，想出于对这位奉献者的敬意去参加这个。Sometimes
devotees, when they go for the cremation, they will chant Hare Krishna, they will do kirtan.
有时候奉献者们他们去火葬场的时候，他们会在那里唱诵 Hare Krishna, Chitana, Kirtan.
And usually after attending a cremation, after seeing a dead body, then it's customary to take bath.
通常呢，就是按照习俗、风俗习惯、传统，去完火葬场的人回来都要去首先沐浴的。
And usually after a person has departed, some few days later, then they'll have a gathering for all the people, all the devotees, and they will talk about that devotee, and they will glorify him, speak some good words about him, and they'll have a meal together. All the devotees, they'll have a feast together, and they will give blessings for that departed soul, for his progress.
刚才补充一下，就凡是见过这个死，就是见过尸体的人，看见了回来都要沐浴。然后就是，奉献者们通常在这个尸体火化几天之后呢，他们会，就是聚会，在聚会过程当中他们会谈论这个奉献者的荣耀，赞美他。
Yes. All right. 还有问题？还有下一个是刀姐。刀姐，刀姐大师。 顶拜孤儿对莲花族，顶拜各位奉献者莲花族，请问孤儿，巴勒迪塔中教导我们要真诚说真话，说话宜人悦人。可是现实生活中，如果讲真话，对方会不太喜欢，正忠言逆耳，这样做会不会冒犯到对方呢？是要调整说话方式，取悦对方，还是要接着说真话呢？ Something about should we speak the truth or can we tell lies, is it?
Bhagavad Gita says we should be truthful and our words should be pleasing. But in practical life, if we speak truth, the others will not like the truth. In traditional Chinese, there's a traditional Chinese proverb that says the truth is not very pleasing. So if we speak truth, we'd offend others, or should we please best of words to please the other, or should we insist on speaking truth?
Well, there's a saying in Sanskrit that we should speak the truth and at the same time make it pleasing.
在梵文当中就是有这么 一句话，真言是说我们要说真话，但是呢 we should speak it in a pleasing way.
Yes.
我们应该以这个悦耳动听的方式来说真话。
Of course, if you're preaching Krishna consciousness, for the sake of preaching Krishna consciousness, we will sometimes say things which are not very pleasing.
当我们传播 Krishna 知识的时候，有的时候呢，我们说的话不会让别人很开心。
So it's a social etiquette to please people. But for preaching, we don't have to follow social etiquette.
按照社会礼仪呢，我们应该是讨好别人，应该让别人开心。但是当涉及到这个传播的时候呢，我们就没必要遵守社会礼仪。
So sometimes we have to say things that may not be pleasing to them. What to do?
So, 有的时候我们的话可能不会让对方高兴，那又能怎办呢？
If it's the truth, people, we have to learn to live with the truth.
我们要学习怎样，跟真理生活在一起。
But try to speak the truth, but try also to make it nice, to please people.
要努力说真话，同时要努力让我们的真话，说美丽的真话，让对方能够开心。
We want to make friends, not enemies.
我们希望与人为友，而不希望与人为敌。
OK， 还有问题吗？
The next one from 陈冠江 Chaitanya Charan Das。Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev。Krishna 佛教梵歌说，怀着爱心，给他一片叶，一朵花，他都接受。在服务 Krishna 的代表 Guru 们的过程中，有时Guru 需要的很简单，但奉献者受不了，他们出于爱心想给 Guru 更多更多，这样的服务是满足自我心意吗？能取悦 Guru 吗？
Yes, it's also pleasing Krishna. Although the Guru doesn't want it for himself, he's happy to see the devotees offer.
是的，这会取悦 Krishna。虽然 Guru 他自己也不需要，但是他看到奉献者的这种供奉的时候，他会开心。
We offer it to Guru. The Guru, you know, he may not, just like you may give the Guru a lot of prasadam, doesn't mean he will eat it all.
就像你给 Guru 做大量的 prasadam, Guru 可能不会都吃掉。
But he's happy to see that you made so many nice things that you were thinking about, you're trying to please him. So it's pleasure for him.
但是当他看到你做了这么多好吃的，想要让 Guru 高兴的时候， Guru 会感到高兴，感到快乐。
Okay. Did I answer?
Yes.
Hare Krishna, good day.
我
看这时间差不多，有一位那个委员苗马大吉，最后一个问题，他想让您讲一讲，Krishna 子女和 Krishna 的这个逍遥时光。
Krishna 什么 ？Krishna 逍遥时光？
孩子
children,
孩子
sons and daughters grandsons the pastor between the sons of Krishna and Krishna Lord.
The sons of Krishna
the children of Krishna this devotee wants to hear the pastime between Lord Krishna and Lord Krishna's children.
Well, Lord Krishna has many children in Dwarka. He has 16,108 wives, and each wife has about 10 children, or 10 sons and one daughter. So he has a lot of children, and some of the sons are more well-known. People like Samba and Prajumna.
Krishna 有许许多的孩子，他娶了16,108位皇后，每一位皇后都为他生了10个儿子和一位女儿。有一些孩子很著名，比如说 Samba, Prajumna。
So, you know, children, they play. They play with each other and they study and like that. You know, Krishna doesn't spend a lot of time with the children.
孩子们呢，他们喜欢玩耍，他们也学习。主 Krishna 没有花很多时间跟孩子们在一起。
They're all his great devotees and they've all come to take part in Lord Krishna's pastimes.
他们都是伟大的奉献者。前来参与主 Krishna 的消时光。
I don't know much about, but no, there's no book describing Krishna's pastimes with the children. I don't know any particular lila about Krishna and his children.
没有很多的书籍来描述主 Krishna 和他的孩子之间的这些消时光。我。不知道。
We hear more about Krishna with his wives.
我们听到很多主 Krishna 和他的妻子们之间的消失光。
You can read the Krishna book. I only know what's in Prabhupada's books. If you read the Krishna book, you'll get everything.
您可以阅读 Krishna 快乐的泉源这本书。就是。我只知道帕帕读的书籍当中的这些消时光。如果您阅读这些书籍，您就会了解一切了。
嗯哼。All right. So we have to stop here, I think.
好的，古德。
Okay. God, 感谢。Guru Mani Gewaman Jingtai Dufani Ganshiya Sati Jujur Ganshiya Sayadu Function Shad Ling Ting Jufu Niman Hau Hau Nin Song Chang Tien Tien Do Chang Damadar Dago Gong Fang Dang Damadar Yo Hami Jia Shu Ayo Iga Sinchi Doa OK Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai
Go back to Vrinda Ki
Jai